Hello, everybody, and welcome to the NIPSI Open Data Site update. My name is Emmy Harbo, and today is June 23rd, 2021. I wanted to inform everybody about the changes we've made to the NIPSI Open Data Site. So as the fire season heats up, you all know what's going on. We've got some new data categories up top. We also have a new geospatial services group called WIFIGS. And WIFIGS provides authoritative geospatial data products under the Interagency Wildland Fire Data Program. And although this is called the Open Data Site or the NIPSI Open Data Site, NIPSI is a place, and we really needed something, a brand to as an umbrella for all of the public-facing data and internal government data that we have accessible in a variety of formats. So when you see the WIFIGS insignia in front of the services, you'll know where that's coming from. And you'll know it's authoritative for wildland fire. Below that announcement is a graphic showing our full history, year to date, and current, and how those services are working. It's really one big data set for the points and polygon services. The perimeter service, in this case, started in March of 2020. The location or the point service is a little bit older. So even though it says full history, it's not really, we're building that out. If you want a complete history through 2020, I would recommend using the Interagency Fire Perimeters History All Years, this data set right here, which is inside the Wildland Fire History group. The way the year-to-date works is you'll see that service. It's everything from January 1st, 2021 on till the current date this year. And then the current service is all the fires that we deem as current. And you can see if you go into the service, you can see what attributes we're using to create that current service. And then another recent change we made is the form for support for the NIPSI Open Data Site. And if you fill out this form, you put your name, a good email address, and fill out everything, especially your issue or question, and we will get back to you shortly. So let's go into a couple of the services. The site looks a little bit different. The 2021 wildland fires, this is what where you'll find your WIFIGS current and wildland fire locations and perimeters, as well as 2021 wildland fire perimeters to date and locations to date, and last 24-hour wildland fire locations, and an ops folder. Let's focus on the current wildland fire perimeters. And as a note, a lot of folks are still using the old service and it says wildfire in it. So if you have a service that says wildfire in it, it is old. It should say wildland fire. It should say WIFIGS current wildland fire perimeters. So if you click into this, you'll see that the look and feel has changed just a little bit because Esri updated their hub sites, which is what we're using. If you want to see the full details about the layer, it will give you a summary here. So you can see that this is a WIFIGS authoritative geospatial data service. It says that the current incidents must meet this criteria in order to be in this service, and then also the fall-off rules. And below that, you'll also see all of the attributes and their definitions. And there's a lot of them. Let me move my head. You can also create a map, create a story map, view the API resources. So if you want to copy this GeoService, if you want to bring the entire service into your ArcGIS Pro, I just copy that link right there, open Pro, add data from path, and then paste that in. And then you've got your current fire perimeters. So that's the easiest way to bring the data in. And then if you save this, it'll always be updated directly from that service. You can view the data source. So you can see all the sources. You can also open it in ArcGIS Online. If you want to filter the data, you can go to this little filter here. And say you just wanted to download one of a specific fire, you can go to View Table. And I'll just search the dog. I'll select the dog fire since it's right there. And if I want to download the dog fire, I toggle this over. It says download one filtered record. And I can download just that record as a CSV, KML, shapefile, GeoJSON, or file geodatabase. And if I want to download the entire data set, it has 99 records. Same thing, you just untoggle that and it'll download the whole data set. So let's go into historic wildland fires. So the WFIGS wildland fire locations full history, that one, as I mentioned, is not truly a full history. That's in progress. And that disclaimer is in the description of the data. Same with the perimeters, full history. I recommend you use the Interagency Fire Perimeter History all years. This is a data set that the authoritative wildland fire groups contribute to, and it's current through the end of 2020. So I definitely recommend that you use this data set. Go back in. There's also a historic perimeters from 2019 from GeoMac, and then historic perimeters combined 2000 to 2018 from GeoMac. And again, if you go into this data set, it'll tell you everything about the data set, the attributes. It has a really nice description. So that's about it from me. I hope that you enjoy these new services, and please don't hesitate to fill out that form if y'all have any questions. Thank you.